Welcome. I'm Andrea Klesse for Woman's Hospital. The gallbladder can cause major problems, as woman's patient Nicole found out when she was treated for gallstones. Dr. Everett Bonner explains how a problem gallbladder can be solved.
My name is Dr. Everett Bonner. I'm a general surgeon in town, also subspecialize in surgical breast oncology. I also take care of breast disease, GI diseases, to include gallbladder disease, hernias, and various other general surgery disease processes. The gallbladder is basically a storage for bile. A bile which is produced in the liver is used to help break down fats. And we use those fats for various things, for hormones and for other processes in the body. Bile is made up of three components. And when any one of those three components get out of equilibrium, you can precipitate stones. And that's how stones are formed. And those stones will precipitate in the gallbladder itself. Once the stones form, there's really no way to get them out. They've tried medicines. They have tried just to extract the stones from the gallbladder. None of those have seemed to work, and the only real way to get them to stop is actually to take the gallbladder out. Once you have stones and once you start having symptoms, it's always recommended to get your gallbladder out, because there are some very bad disease processes that can occur as the symptomatology increases and as the risk of stones, which can get dislodged from the gallbladder and block up ducts, to include the common duct, which can cause what we call an ascending cholangitis and cause a liver infection. But much worse, if that stone gets out and blocks up the pancreatic duct, you can get pancreatitis, which has a high morbidity, otherwise known as death. Nicole came to see me for the classic right upper quadrant pain, which is very typical of persons who are suffering with gallbladder disease. Most patients, as Nicole, usually come in with right upper quadrant pain, sometimes radiating to the back, and it's especially associated with certain foods, mostly fat foods, fried foods. Seems to exacerbate that. But that's not always the case for every patient. Some patients just experience bloating. Some just experience a fullness feeling. Others experience nausea and vomiting. Some have pain radiating to the right shoulder, some up into the neck. There's various different symptomatology for this type of disease. Some people have all of them, some people only have a few, some people just have some very vague symptoms. You know, most patients nowadays, the surgery is done laparoscopically. Four small incisions, one of which is about 1 centimeter, which is usually what the gallbladder comes out, plus the stones. The other are about 5 millimeters, or a quarter of an inch. It's done all through the scopes. Only about 3 to 5% of the patients have to go the old open procedure, and that's usually for advanced disease, or if they've had previous surgeries where there's scarring on the inside, or patients who have abnormal anatomy and it's unsafe to proceed laparoscopically. Fortunately, that's very rare nowadays, because we are getting better with the laparoscope, which was first started around 1990 for GI diseases. The recovery period for most patients is fairly well tolerated. Usually a day or two, patients are a little uncomfortable, usually trying to get over the anesthesia and the initial pain. Most patients, I find, do not have to go on heavy narcotics, maybe for the first day to sleep at night. For most patients, just regular Tylenol or Motrin is just good enough for their pain control. After about 3 to 5 days, most patients, as long as they don't do manual labor, can go back to work. If you have a desk job or in a supervisor role, you're still not going to feel 100% for about 2 weeks. But most patients by 3 days are itching to get out and get back into their normal lifestyle. I always recommend to patients, even with the small incisions, not to do any heavy physical activity or exercise or lifting more than about 25 pounds for at least 2 weeks, just so cosmetically the incisions will heal well and they don't have any problems with the wounds themselves. Unfortunately, with gallbladder disease, you know, diet can only do so much. A lot of times you see it run in families. It's basically what happens is they form stones, and then once they form stones, it's really after that point the diets can only, you know, keep symptoms from occurring as often. But eventually, once they occur, it's inevitable that their gallbladder is going to come out. Staying away from fried and fatty foods, anything that's oily, butters and sweets, can decrease the symptoms. But once the symptoms start, they're going to be persistent until the gallbladder is removed. Most patients who present with gallbladder disease are females in their 40s who are fertile, who have a high fat diet. And that's typical presentation. However, in Louisiana in the South, a lot of us have those same characteristics as far as our diet's concerned. And so you see it in a younger population and an older population, and you can also see it in males. But the most common is the middle-aged female and strictly on diet. I think with any recommendation that's from the American Heart Society, American Cancer Society, and any one of the health groups that are out there, a normal healthy diet will probably limit your symptoms and also keep you healthy. So if you stay on that track, maybe you're less likely to have gallbladder disease. It's hard to tell.
For more information, visit womans.org. Womans, exceptional care centered on you.